things to be remembered, but this one is the most unforgettable moment for me. It's hiking in Saxon Switzerland in 2014, because it was the first time I hiked ever in my life with sledding. So this is the picture when we took when we did hiking in Saxon Switzerland. It was on 10th of October 2014. Sladis has, and one of our friends from first lover door, Sladi, went hiking there. If you look at the second picture, you see that these nerds try to analyze the map, but one life was there because we just finished our GIS pre-course class. But still, we couldn't find the way to the left side bridge, and we lost our way sometimes. But anyway, it's really enjoyable time for us to go up together, eat lunch together up there, and enjoy the beautiful scenery. It's also taking many pictures as you want. Thank you.
Really good. We also went to the National Park. large fish on the worry cycle, helping our hands on our weight, like we can do all these things. And we also saw some aircraft and rockets in NASA and got motivated for our life in the future. Thanks.
So I took this teacher and another family that I have with this teacher. In here we are saying bye bye Netherlands and say hello to Spain. So another day is coming that we are saying again bye bye to Netherlands. But I want to say to my friends, if there is another way, day that we give you together. So be happy and we will be together again. And also I had my selfie that was my birthday that my family gave it to me. I promise I give it, I keep it for next time when we again when we do it.
Thank you.
And then they said, okay, we're going to eat sea monsters. And we're all like, okay, but where's Barcelona? Why not? So it all started like this. We were all together eating, and we were talking about unforgettable things. But actually, there's some people forgot a bit after this. Because then, after some bottles of wine, we were like this. And it all ended up like this. Many people don't even remember this picture. I include myself. But yeah, I was really nice.
We studied a lot in the last 2 years, but also, of course, we needed something to balance this. For me personally, it was music, and we cannot quite see where in the left picture, but we, in all the places we went to, we attended like open microphones, evenings, and vibes, and even jam sessions in Ljubljana, for example, here, where people just occupied and, yeah, some old left ruin, and just in winter, try to heat up the place with candles, and we sat down there with a lot of exchange students from other programs, but also those Korean people to play music. And also, the Italian evening we played in an open mic in Ljubljana, and here with a friend of Fabio in Barcelona and wife. And yeah, we had a lot of music together. The first experience was Boom's birthday, which we presented. And the last one for now is today, but I'm sure there will be more to do.
So here we are in the beautiful city of Ljubljana. So it's Christmas time, and yeah, this memory is two Italians and a German go shopping in Ljubljana. We meet the French, but so we went to the, yeah, it was 8 in the morning, super early, and the weather was so bad. We walked for maybe 2 hours to reach this market because they were selling everything. Like selling, I don't know, Fabio wanted to buy some lights for the car or something. I don't know. And then at the end we ended up with two bikes, one oven, a Christmas tree. And we all get back and came with this stuff 2 hours away, like a few kilometers away from the market. It was pretty nice.
Behind there is a Dutch beer, people like that in Bavaria. Thank you for promoting that.
Where heart is, part of my heart is always in Greece.
Thank you.
You may be seated now. Dear participants, honored guests, colleagues, good afternoon. It's my pleasure to welcome you to the graduation day of the Erasmus Mundus Masters and Software Management Diploma Award. I would now like to give the floor to Dr. Johan van Dijk, our business director, the business director of UNESCO-IHE. Johan.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, dear guests, dear students, and dear colleagues. It's my pleasure to welcome you to Delft, to UNESCO-IHE, and to have you as guests at our graduation ceremony of the Erasmus Mundus Programme for Flood Risk Management. I would like to have a warm welcome first to the professors of the partner institutes that are participating in the programme. Professor Christian Bernhofer from the Technical University of Dresden, Professor Alan Bateman of the Technical University of Catalonia, Professor Mitya Brilli of University of Ljubljana, and of course the colleagues from UNESCO-IHE. I would also like to mention the partners of this program. We have a number of associated partners. And these include Deltaris, which is based here in Delft, the DIHI Group, Wellingford, Rijkswaterstaat, IHM of Japan, and the Institute of Water Modeling in Bangladesh. And of course, the warm welcome mainly to the students. And you are the fourth batch that is graduating. We have 15 in total. There are 15 in total. You will develop in the future as water leaders in flood risk management. That is something that is going to happen in your future. And we're very proud to have you with us, and we congratulate you with your achievements. This is a truly international program, because you have been traveling from Germany to the Netherlands, and then to Spain, and then to Slovenia, which is almost full circle over the European continent. And what we like very much about this program is this international character, because it provides you the insight on the matters of content of flood risk management, but also puts you in a position to work and live in different conditions with different partners, different groups in the different countries you have been working with. And I'm sure that also later in your career you will think of all these impressions and these experiences that you've now gained. For us in UNESCO-IHE, it is of course also important, this European program, mainly for profiling, let's say, the European side of our program. We have a lot of international projects, but the European profile is very important. And I take it for granted that it also holds for the other partner institutes that are present here. In this context, of course, we do thank the European Commission who made it all possible, and I hope also that we can continue in an extension after this four-year program with colleagues or future colleagues of yours. But now it is your day. I'm very happy for you. I also remember the day when I took my first diploma, a day that you will never forget. So I hope it will stay in your memory for a very long time. And with this, I thank you all for your presence, and I would like to invite First Dmitry Solomitin of UNESCO-IHE to continue with the ceremony. Thank you very much.
Dear colleagues, I was telling you, I think, that every speech consists of five parts. First the joke, then you say what you will be talking about, then you talk about it, then you summarize, and fifth part is again a joke. So today I'm badly prepared, I have only three parts, so no jokes. Serious stuff. Johan already thanked so many people. I would join these words of gratitude towards my colleagues from various universities, from UNESCO-IHE, from our associated partners for participating in this program. You may also think in your mind European Union that provided some of the funding which was streaming in to this program, quite considerable funding, and we hope European Union would survive to continue this funding. It was a joke, but fine. Some of you said in your acknowledgments in the thesis that it was the best decision in their life they made. I'm not sure that's fully correct, but I think, dear participants, you have made a good decision. So first of all, and this is first part I would like to cover here, because I have three parts, as I said, it's about knowledge. So you acquired a lot of knowledge, and perhaps you even would know soon how to apply it. Because typically you come to a company and they say, well, forget everything you learned at the university or at master, you know, like a terrible dream, we'll teach you how to do things. So still, I hope if you would be able to use at least 20-25% of what you have learned here in real practice, it would not be that bad. So I think that was a good part of this program. Second, I would like to cite Albert Einstein, imagination is more important than knowledge. I was trying to say during master's studies that, look, the most important thing is ideas and not the work that you do. Because if you have wonderful ideas, there would be enough people to do work for you. So think about this in the future. So imagination is more important than knowledge. So imagine how to apply this knowledge. That's much more difficult than to learn, I suppose. So it's sort of a small word of wisdom sent by professors towards students. Third component is human component of this program. Just half an hour ago, we have seen how much have you achieved in this program. You've been to the mountains, you've been on the sea, you've been to Florida, you saw a kissy-missy, if you remember correctly, missy-kissy-missy-kissy. So you have shown that you created a great network of friends, and this is perhaps even more important than imagination, because you say it's impossible to I think Miusha, you said impossible to lose true friends. Eh? So that's, you may lose the knowledge, but true friends, it's impossible to lose. That's maybe one of the important achievements of this program. And just a couple of weeks ago, I was reading almost 20 theses of yours, and the best part, you know what it was? It was acknowledgments. It was really great to read these emotional pieces of text, which were almost poems. I thought you would, you know, stumble, and you would start producing verses instead of, you know, prose. It was that close. And you were in this family. You learned how to ride a bicycle, you remember? Yes? And it was all reflected also in acknowledgments. You learned languages You learn how to eat paella and even how to pronounce it, and how to drink wine and beer and all this. And being in the Netherlands, you have learned how to say 88 prachtige grachten, isn't it? That was sorry, maybe I also making mistake, but I'm trying. In 26 years in the Netherlands, I'm getting closer and closer. So very soon I will be pronouncing this correctly. It means 88 beautiful canals, actually. So I hope you enjoyed canals and Delft, Amsterdam, and elsewhere. And I would like to cite one of the acknowledgments here, which says the following. I got surprised about discovering my passion for modeling. We mean mathematical modeling, computer-based modeling. Don't think it's modeling. When you type in Google models, you get different models. It's not these models. We use mathematical modeling. I expected to be annoyed and frustrated by modeling errors and hundreds of lines of code. Instead, I enjoyed it, and it was more like a flow experience. And then in brackets, for everybody who is engaging with the science of happiness. I would like to wish you that you would always be discovering new and new areas of science of happiness. Thank you very much, dear participants.
Now we proceed with the part that you've all been waiting for, the actual awarding of the diploma. I will call out your name for a while, and then you can step forward. First, I call to the floor Mr. Feinfried from the Netherlands.
We're looking for the photographer.
Yeah. Wow. Congratulations. Thank you. organize him that.
Nice to meet you. Thank you.
Mr. Sai from Italy. And the last one from this first group, Mrs. Albrecht from Germany with this speech.
Now we learned after 20.
That's it. My role is finished.
Before we continue with the next names, I would first like to invite Professor Christian Bernhofer to come to the.
Thank you very much. I have to say something. So I've always needed some notes to do this. Dear graduates, dear colleagues, dear representatives of IHE, please let me say a few words on behalf of dear Dresden, one of those institutions involved in the Erasmus Mundus Flood Risk Management Program. Today we see again 15 brilliant young women and young men finishing their degree and becoming masters. Flood risk evaluation, guidance, avoidance, retention, evolution, protection, prediction, etc. The names are numbered. So time to celebrate, time to look back and ahead. But maybe also important, you have traveled as a group an unusual journey from Dresden to Delft to Barcelona and to Ljubljana. Then again you traveled to one of the few of the four partners or associated institutions to work on your thesis, and we saw lots of interesting information from this travel. Your first scientific achievement, thanks to your ambitious work and the dedication of your supervisors. Then you defended. Now we are back to Delft for graduation. All of you did it in time, almost all of you. Great. It's been two demanding years. You have been guided by some of the best flood experts in Europe and worldwide. Not all of your questions could be answered, as always with science. But I'm sure you gained a lot, also besides teaching and learning. But something as a side effect of the program, very important, you traveled together. And as an African proverb says, if you want to travel fast, travel alone. If you want to travel far, travel together. You were traveling far and quite fast. This traveling was by no means easy. You had to overcome and learn the specifics of four teaching systems and four different universities, four different countries. You had to master the challenges of daily life in each of the countries, housing, banking, whatever, local transportation, etc. And to travel from the study location to the next. And you mastered, truly mastered, also these challenges. And I'm sure it was also often very joyful to organize these traveling events. We saw quite a few things from that. So if you want to travel far, travel together, something to be kept in mind. Well done, Masters of Science. The same holds for your academic hosts. They all had to solve some extra tasks, even in the fourth year. It's not always been an easy routine. Not for TU Dresden, not for IHE, not for Barcelona, not for Ljubljana. But together we managed to arrive at your goal of those 4 years, to become a master in flood risk management. So you now are ready for professional life, ready to be agents of change, as Dimitri sometimes put it, ready to be propagators of science and also propagators as engineers of engineering solutions. You can be proud of your achievements. Congratulations.
Thank you, Professor Bernhofer. Now we continue with him. Islamic Republic of Iran.
This is the most important one.
Yes. You first collect all the material and then make
it. And we put it like that. Then in the photo, you can come, take your flower and the book.
And the book you can hold.
And the book. Sorry, I helped you.
Sorry for this.
Yes. Now photo.
Before we go with the next names, I first invite Professor Bateman.
Okay.
This is my cat. Sleeping. Oh my God.
Slow.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, students, all the students. I saw two or three all the students. Normally I have to do a speech. Every year we have to do a speech. Every year we have to invent something. I have to contract a writer.
That's a problem. But we use a random number generator.
Yes, very difficult, very difficult. This is not the end. This is more than that. It is the new point to start your life. Okay? But the importance is not the end, not the starting point, but the path. It's very important, the path. You have to enjoy it. You have to be happy when you do things. I learned that in India. Yes, it's very nice. The path is the more important. It's not the end, it's not the point of starting. Congratulations to all of you. I hope. I don't know, last night, I don't know that, but I hope that Mr. Piyush have to learn to play the flute. I hope Anne-Marie is still doing beautiful questions. Anne-Marie, here. I hope Mr. Han change the glad might change. I hope Mr. Josias find the environmental point objective. Environmental point. I hope that all of you love your flat risk management course and path. I hope that Dimitris continues making these beautiful jokes.
We need participants to do it.
Okay, I hope that you will enjoy all this celebration. Okay, thank you very much. It's a short speech. Okay, thank you.
We continue with Mr. Lee from Vietnam.
Take the photo like this way. Yes.
Who gave the book?
You give the book,
and hold it behind it, take a good photo,
okay.
Like this. Okay, now it's time. Smile.
Okay, smile.
Yes.
Okay, well done.
Congratulations.
And Mr. Risse from Germany.
Congratulations. You have to take this.
Congratulations.
You have to sorry. Hold it behind it. It comes in the picture, believe me. Yes, I now give a good smile. Yes.
Thank you, Professor Bateman. I would now like to invite Professor Mitja Billy to come to the floor.
Okay. Thank you much for this opportunity, because you pass through quite a difficult study. It was not easy for you. You are challenged with the different universities, different culture, and so on. But it's very important, because finally you finish in Slovenia as a country in transition. But you should recognize also that today, thanks to the climate change, all the nature is in transition. And the European Union, who help and finance this study, is also in transition, and almost also worldwide we have transition. And I think that this program help you in the future to understand what is going on. Teaching and learning is and collect the knowledge is somehow a very complex process, and I should say that you learn me a lot. Thank you very much.
And now for the stage, Mrs. Dagmar Dasla from Sri Lanka.
Where's the book? You give the book, Mitja.
Yes, give it to her. And you hold it. Like this way. And now we can give a good smile.
Thank you, Professor Bari. I now ask Dimitri to come back to the stage, and I ask Mr. Hadi Mohammad Sadeh Khani from the Islamic Republic of Iran.
I'm sure I will shake your hand very soon.
Yeah. Okay.
Thank you. Well done.
Thank you.
Congratulations. Well done. So we'll arrange another photo for you. Okay.
Thank you.
It's my pleasure to congratulate you all with your well-deserved master diploma. I hope you have enjoyed the experience here in the Netherlands and that you will stay in contact with our institute. I would like to stress that this diploma is a unique diploma. Handle it with care. The institute does not hold copies of it. I therefore strongly advise you to make photocopies of it and a PDF before you take it home to keep it safe. I would now like to invite our business director, Johan Aert, to close the ceremony.
Thank you very much. It was a lovely event to see all these cheery faces in the first row. As I mentioned, it brings me back to my own time when I got my diploma, and I know that you feel wonderful. And we would like to continue with ceremony outside for a picture first, and then we have drinks in the restaurant, and we can just follow with it. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Sorry for the meeting. Congratulations.